Hello children, welcome back to our mathematics class and hope all of you are fine and fit at your home. And today we are going to start a new exercise, that is exercise number 4.6, and this we will simplify here with the four operation together, that means plus, minus, multiplication and division in the numerical expression. Is it clear, students? So you can see the book here, simplify the following. The question number 1 is, we'll start with our question number A. So let's move to the exercise questions. A is given 17 plus 27 divided by 3 minus 2 into 3. So as we have to follow this DMAS, we have to follow this rule to solve this numerical expression. With clear, student? So we have to do the division work at first. So 27 divided by 3, that means 9. Okay, so now we have to move to the multiplication work. So 2 into 3 means we have to, you will get 6. Now, so after getting 6, we have to do, we cannot subtract it, we have to do the addition work first. So 17 plus 9, it is 26. So 26 minus 6, 20. Okay, students, you have understood it. Now I'm going to show you one more thing, that is question C number. So see here, 100 into 2 plus 98 divided by 2 minus 102. So how we'll do it? Same way we apply it here also, we have to do the division work at first. So 98 divided by 2, how we'll do? You can see here, this 2 4, see 98 if we'll divide, 2 4 8. So now 9 minus 8 1 and 8 will carry 18. So 2 9 18, that means it will be 49. So I have written here directly. All right, now 49, and here we have to multiply. So 100 into 2, 200, and now we have to add. So 200 plus 49 is 249. Now we'll subtract it 102. So 102 will subtract it from 249. So how will subtract? You can see here, 9 minus 2, same way, 9 minus 2, 7. Now 4 minus 0, 4, 2 minus 1, 1. So these we can write here also. Alright, students, now we'll move to our next question, that is, I have written here already, E number. Okay, so let's see our E number question, that is 118 plus 12 minus 3 into 100 divided by 10. So we have to do the division work first. So this one will do at first. 100 divided by 10 means it's 10. As 10 into 10, you will get 100, so it will be 10. Okay, now we have to do the multiplication work. So this one we'll have to write the same. Now we'll do this one, this part. So 10, 3 into 10, it will be 30. Okay, now we will have to do the addition work. Okay, students, so let's see. 118 plus 12, how much we'll get? You can add, if you can add like this also, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 means we'll have right here 0 and 1 will carry over. So 1 plus 1, 2 and plus 1, 3. So 3 and 1 will be same, 1. So 130 minus 30, you will get here 0, 0 and 3 minus 3, 0, 1 will be same. So it's 100. Is it clear, students? So this is our result. Now I'm going to show you one more thing, that is H number. Then H number, you can see here, you may get puzzle of same this type of question, that as the digit is same. All the digit or all the number you can see here same. 3 into 3 minus 3 divided by 3 plus 3. Okay, so now we'll start the solving it or simplifying it. So how we'll simplify it? At first we'll see the division work. 3 divided by 3, how we can write 3 divided by 3? We will write here 1. Okay, 1 I have written here. Now we'll do the multiplication work. So move to 3 into 3, it's 9. So 9 I have written, and minus 1, this 3 will be same. Now we can see here, if we'll do the, we have to do the addition work. You can see that 9 as 9 minus 1 plus 3. So this is 9 means what? And no sign is it before the 9, that means it's plus. So 9 we have, and this is also plus. So this 2, as you know, we have to follow the DM Yes, and you have to do the addition work first. So 9 plus 3 will do, then we'll subtract it from 1. So 9 plus 3 means it's 12 minus 1, we'll get here 11. So that's the only I have written here. It will be 3. I have not arranged in together, but you can arrange together in one more line. You can write here, then we can do it. Okay, so it will be 12 minus 1 is 11. I hope this is clear to you how to simplify the numerical expression using all the form operation together. Okay, now let's move to the another question, sir. So you can see here 48 divided by 4 plus 12 into minus 2 into 2. So how we'll start the solving or simplifying it? Now we'll start simplifying it with the division work at first. So 48 divided by 4 will do it first. So 48 divided by 4 will get here 12. As you know that if you have learned the table of 12, as I have told, you must learn the table of 1 to 20. Okay, students, is it clear? You have to learn. So 4, 12 for the 48. So you will write here 4, 12. So now we see here plus 12 minus 2 into 2. So what work we have to do at first? Now after over this division work, we have to do the multiplication work. So this all will be same. Now we have to do the product. So 2 into 2, 4. Now we have to do the addition work. Okay, students, so how we'll do? Add 2 plus 2, it will be 4, and 1 plus 1, it will be 2. Now we have to subtract the 4 from 24. So 4 minus 4, it will be 0, and 2 will be same. So this is our result. I hope you have understood it also. Now I'm going to show you one more question, that is I number. So let's see. This is 62 minus 2 plus 4 into 121 divided it by 11. So which one we have to do at first, students? This division work we have to do it first. Okay, so 62 minus 2 plus 4 into what one? So as if you have learned the table of 12, you know that 11 is 121. So you can directly write here 11, as it will divide here 121 by 11. You can write same way, you can get also 12 minus 11 is 1 and 1, so it will be 1. So it's same. Or if you have learned already the table of 11, so you can directly also get this answer. So it will be 12. Alright. Now, after doing this division work, we have to do the multiplication work. So next line, we will do the multiplication work. So 62 minus 2 plus 4 into 11, it will be 44. Okay, 4 into 4, 1 is 4, 4, 1 is 4. So now we have to do the addition work. So these two we have to add. I have written here arranged together. You can directly also can do these two, you have to add. And this is a plus sign and this is also plus. Now after that, you have to subtract. So 2 plus 4, it will be 6, and 6 plus 4, it will be 10. That means 106. Now we have to subtract 2 from 2. From 106, so 6 minus 2 will be 4, and 0 will be same, that 100 will be same. So it's very easy. You have got the 104. This is the result. So is it clear, students? Now I'm going to show you one more thing. This last one, J number. You can see in your book that's given. You can see J number is 80, then plus 10 divided it by 10 into 2 minus 61. So how we'll do it first? So you have to do with the division work at first. Okay, so 80 plus 10 divided by 10 means it will be 1 into 10, 2, 61. So this 2 you have to do. Next line you will do the multiplication work. So 1 to 2, it will be 2, then 61 you have to subtract. Now you can see these two you have to add. So 80 plus 2, it will be 82, minus 61 is there. So now 2 minus 1, it is 1, and 8 minus 6 is 2. So this is the result. I hope this is clear to you now, how we can simplify or solve the numerical expression with the various operation or four operation together, plus, minus, multiplication, then addition, or sorry, so division. Okay, so using this DMAS formula, and for this much for today, I'm saying you, and we have now completed our the chapter number 4, and now I'm going to give you a few recapitulation of this chapter. Some points I'm saying you, that's so in this chapter whatever things we have learned, you can see here that all the things we have learned here in this multiplication and division of large numbers. See the properties of multiplication we have learned, yes or no students? And we have learned about the division properties also, okay, and how to solve the multiplication work, how to divide with the numbers of large numbers, and how to do this division sum using that we can give, how we can find out the dividend with the help of the division sum, like this one, whatever this course, that recursion into divisor plus remainder will get dividend. This way also this all we have learned in this chapter, and how we can solve the problem of the multiplication with 10, 100, 1000 without actual division, and how we can solve the division work without actual division by 100, 10, 1000 and so on. Is that clear? So in this chapter all the things we have learned, and we have learned this also, that how that we can product is always greater than the multiplicand and the multiplier, except the multiplier is 0 or 1. This thing we have to learn, okay? We should know it. And as you know, that product of two numbers does not change if the order of the numbers being multiplied is changed, okay? And one more thing I am saying, you must say that the remainder should always be smaller than the divisor. This all the things we have learned in this chapter, yes or no students? Isn't it? So I hope you have understood this complete chapter, and you practiced at your home all the things you know down in your copy, or write it or practice in your copy, okay? Thank you.